All right, people. I just wanted to clear the air here, just to be very specific, because people are running wild with these little stories and everything else that's transpired or what's going on or this or that or what started it, right? So this whole little drama escapade actually started on, there was a trailer for the next episode, right? Actually, it's airing tonight at 8 p.m. on Lifetime. I think it is. So there's a trailer and like Haley's cackling and talking about how she couldn't run fast enough out of somewhere. And so I commented saying, well, gee, I guess we're gonna need full context, but maybe I shouldn't be as nice when I do interviews, or maybe I should spill some tea of my own, right? Since she's gonna go on TV and just basically try to talk guff or like humiliate me again on national television or try to, right? I made that comment on Instagram, and then as a result, they see it, and Virginia proceeds to be a proxy for Haley, try to tell me that I need to shut my mouth and I shouldn't be talking about Haley at all and to move on and all these things. And it's like, well, I don't talk about Haley at all, except I do answer some questions on lives, because that's how life works. When you're on a show, you get to ask questions about the show, and I'm going to give my perspective sometimes on those questions, depending on what they are. You know, via this proxy telling me to shut my mouth, and it's like basically like threatening me with all the girls won't like me or won't talk to me after. And it's like, okay, like, look, I have very shitty experience with Haley. I'm sure she feels the same way. I should be able to talk about that and tell the truth without offending anybody. And if that offends them in some sort of way where they don't want to talk with me, then but I'm not going to like not give my perspective on things that I'm allowed to give my perspective on, because somebody else doesn't like it. So that's just the bottom line with that. Okay. So I'm on the live and I happen to get these questions again. And some of them are more insulting things that she had brought up on national television to try and humiliate me, after the fact, right? We're at the reunion and she's talking about how like it was the sex, right, that had her shut down and that she was done, that she just couldn't connect. Right. It was all those things and the snickering. So somebody had mentioned that, and then I talked a little bit about that with my perspective. And of course, I think that was too much for them. Although it's like, you're the one dogging me on national TV. Like, okay. And again, the real story behind that whole thing, I'm not going to get into details, but it's not what people probably think. It's much more less eventful, and it wasn't good all around, and it wasn't for her either or for me, and that's just what it is. So but I'm not gonna like really play tit for tat with that in particular, but I do want to be able to speak my mind and talk about things, right, that I'm allowed to talk about. So I do feel like it's, I don't know, like, then, you know, I guess Virginia feels a certain way about it, right, comes in wanting to get on the live and probably just, I guess, yell at me or talk over me or whatever, and I'm not really interested in that. And the way she was typing, it didn't seem like she was in a good place to be actually discussing anything, much less in a live stream. So wasn't interested, didn't do it. But then she just proceeds to keep going, right, with all this stuff and like essentially like trying to blackmail me into silence somehow with some text messages, which I think that's a bad thing to do if you're an influencer. I don't think you should be publicly blackmailing people and threatening to like release things. I don't think that's a good thing for blue check marks, but I could be wrong. And then talks about how I have the lowest follower count out of maths and like all these things just insulting me left and right. And it's like, I don't go after and insult Haley. I never initiate conversation about Haley. Okay. So let's just get that straight. And I wish her the best, honestly. I don't like her as a person. As together, we were very bad. But I don't wish her ill will. I hope she finds her person, gets her shit together and lives a happy life. Like, that's as far as I'm concerned. But if I go on a live stream and I get 20 questions about something and then somebody asks me something specific that was pretty insulting to me, I try to set the record straight within the bounds that I'm allowed to. So, and they're unhappy about that, right? So, look, tough. I don't know. Like, I'm talking about the public knowledge stuff, the stuff that's been released, stuff that's been on TV, and I'm just giving my little twist or perspective on it. I don't know what to tell you. So I know we like to control everybody's speech these days and try to tell everybody what they can and can't do. I just, I don't see a big deal with me answering a question or two on a live stream in regards to some of the more insulting things she said about me on national television. So if you really have a problem with that, I think you should probably stop enabling her and just say, you know, like, look, you probably shouldn't have said that. It's a big deal if he says it on live stream to 50 people or 100 people, right, whatever it was. And instead, right, you blow up, go nuclear, do this thing, and now it's what? All over the place. Everybody's talking about it. And gee, it's a huge mess, right? So, and I'm not interested in this shit. Like, I don't want to, like, be going back and forth about, like, this stuff and talking about these things. It's just not interesting to me. Like, I was talking about Eddie Murphy in The Golden Child and how great he was and improvising on that role and how fucking funny. And he was like, I want the knife. And then Virginia comes in with these heaters, like, talking all this massive shit out of nowhere. And I did reference, she was trying to, like, silence me essentially earlier too. So maybe that got her goat, but it's the truth. And then it's like weird threatening me with like a blackmail type thing of with these text messages. Like, that blew me away. It's like, do you always blackmail people publicly or just do that privately usually? I was like, Jesus Christ. Like, I don't know. But you know what? Like, I'm not trying to make enemies in the cast and all that stuff. Look, our season, I think, is agreed upon probably one of the worst seasons or whatever. Like, that's the consensus online. It's enough of a shit show. I don't really want to be going back and forth with these people or talking about this stuff. So I just want to clear the air. This is my real perspective. Again, I don't go around talking about Haley like that. But if I'm on a live and people are asking these questions, I think it's fair to just answer the question with my perspective. That's of things that are public knowledge and were aired on TV. So that's all that is. I guess either deal with it or don't. Block me. Live your life. Nobody's going to care in like a day or two. Like, people's attention spans, they just flutter, you know? Like, nobody's going to care. Just move on. Like, I don't care. Talk about me. Say what you want. I don't care. Peace.